Hello and welcome to NBC News. You are watching English Bulletin with me, Ratnakar. News in detail. Former Chief Minister and opposition BJP leader Devendra Fadnavis lambasted Shiv Sena and called it as a confused party. Fadnavis made the remark while speaking on the farm bill in Nagpur. Fadnavis added, Shiv Sena is a confused party and it can't even take a stand on many issues, and now they have got used to it. This does not surprise us now. Stating that Shiv Sena took a different stand on the bill in Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha, Fadnavis said, when they were with us in power, they behaved like a party of the government as well as the opposition. Shiv Sena needs to decide on its stand. It has not put forth any stand related to farming. Now it is ruling the state. Several farmers have died by suicide in the state. If Sanjay Raut is asking so much, can his government give an assurance that farmers will not end lives in the state? It is nothing but politics. In view of the increasing spread of COVID-19 in the city, city police set up Nagpur Police COVID-19 Hospital, which was inaugurated virtually by Home Minister Anil Deshmukh and Guardian Minister Dr. Nitin Raut on Monday, September 21st. The 16-bedded hospital facility, which has been set up near police headquarters, has been designed for cops who have been serving the city since lockdown. City Police Commissioner Amitesh Kumar, Nagpur Municipal Corporation Commissioner Radhakrishnan B, Special Inspector General of Police Nagpur Range Chiranjeev Prasad, Joint Commissioner of Police Nilesh Verne, Superintendent of Police Nagpur Rural Rakesh Ola, doctors and several DCPs were present for the same. 3 days back, Cabinet Minister Dr. Nitin Raut, along with his wife Sumedha, tested positive for coronavirus. The senior Congress leader's wife was admitted to Alexis Hospital for further treatment. A 7-month pregnant doctor from Amaravati, Dr. Pratiksha Valdikar Gavai, who was working as a pathologist at District Government General Hospital, Aravind Hospital in Amaravati, succumbed to COVID-19. Valdikar, who was serving as a frontline COVID-19 warrior until 2 weeks before her demise, was brought to Nagpur for the COVID-19 treatment. The 32-year-old, who was kept on ventilator for 10 days, was said to have completed her post-graduation from Nagpur. The Vidarbha Rajya Andolan Samiti recently raised the demand for reserving 75% posts for candidates from Vidarbha region in the police recruitment drive announced recently. Ram Nevale, VRAS convener, said that out of the 12,528 posts for which recruitment will be carried out, 75% of the posts should be reserved for Vidarbha domicile candidates. This, he said, is a fair and justified demand considering the decades of injustice meted out to the region by various state government. Nevale warned that otherwise the member of the organization will carry out protest demonstration all over the state, along with unemployed youth. Nevale and other office bearers said that as per the 1953 Nagpur Act, 23% of all government jobs were supposed to be reserved for Vidarbha domicile candidates, but this has rarely been implemented, leading to backwardness of Vidarbha. The kidnapping of two teenagers from the city have come to light. The first incident occurred under the jurisdiction of Mankapur police station. The victim is a 14-year-old girl who yesterday went out of her home situated in the vicinity of Sadiqabad passport office. She had not informed her parents while going out, with his daughter not coming back home even at night. The complainant reported the incident at the Mankapur police station. Upon investigation, it came to light that accused Vishal Getam has kidnapped the girl. The second incident occurred near Yashodharanagar police station. Bande Nawaz Nagar resident Durga Bhavankar's son too similarly went out and did not return home, following which she registered a complaint with cops. Cases of kidnapping have been registered by police in both instances, and search operations has been commenced to trace the missing children. As many as 48 persons succumbed to COVID-19 on Monday. With this, the cumulative death toll in the district has now reached to 2,094. On the other hand, as many as 1,994 persons have gone home after recovered and obtaining permission from authorities. With this, the total number of recovered patients is now 53,550, including 30,180 patients who recovered during home isolation and treatment. The recovery rate of the district is now at 82.25%, which is a positive development. The total corona positive cases tally of Nagpur district is now at 65,107, with 1,350 positive cases coming to light in the last 24 hours. While giving a breakup of the deaths, medical officials revealed that out of the total casualties, 347 and 1558 victims are from the rural and urban areas of the district respectively, while 189 persons are from outside Nagpur. Well, that's all from this bulletin. For more updates in and around the city, stay tuned with NBC News. Till then, Ratnakar says goodbye. Please take very good care of yourself.